Good morning, students. In the last video, we have discussed about cupola furnace. Similar to cupola furnace, this crucible furnace is also used to melt metals. So, what is crucible furnace? In these furnaces, the entire melting of metal takes place inside a melting pot called crucible, which is made of clay and graphite. There is no direct contact between the flame and the metal charge. In cupola furnace, the metal charge and coke was mixed and the flame is in direct contact with the metal charge. But here, the metal charge is kept inside a crucible, a pot, and there is no direct contact between the flame and the metal. These furnaces are used for melting non-ferrous metal and their alloy to produce small and medium-sized castings in foundries. These furnaces can be classified into two groups as follows: coke-fired furnaces and oil and gas-fired furnaces. These furnaces are generally installed in a formed pit. They are provided with refractory lining inside and a chimney at the top, just like cupola. So, refractory lining to prevent heat and a chimney for escaping the flue gases, the burnt gases. Both natural as well as artificial draughts can be used to draw air into the furnace. Broken pieces of metal are placed in the crucible. Bed coke is fired in the furnace and the crucible placed into it. Afterwards, more coke is placed all around the crucible. The heat generated by burning of the coke melts the metal inside the crucible. These are used for melting small quantities of ferrous metals, pig iron, for producing iron casting, but mostly used for non-ferrous metals and alloys. Coke is used as fuel. So this is the diagram of pit type coke fired crucible furnace. So with the help of a blower, air is drawn into the furnace and coke is burnt surrounding the crucible, and a chimney is there for removing the burnt gases. These furnaces, next is oil or gas fired furnace. The previous one was coke fired. So coke is used as fuel, but in this case, in second type, oil or gas is used as fuel. These furnaces utilize oil or gas as a fuel. A mixture of gas and air or oil and air is fed into the furnace, which burns inside to produce the desired temperature. The mixture usually enters tangentially and encircles the crucible while burning. These furnaces may be of stationary type or tilting type. The latter type are more preferred because it can tilt, help removing of the crucible. The furnace construction of stationary type gas fired furnaces. The furnace essentially consists of a cylindrical steel shell provided with refractory lining inside and proper passage for entry of the fuel mixture, gas and air. The crucible is seated on a pad formed at the bottom. A cover is provided at the top to prevent heat losses. So this is the diagram of stationary type gas fired crucible furnace. So as described, so gas and air mixture entered into the furnace chamber, which is burnt, and the flame encircles the crucible. The crucible contains the metal to be melted, and due to this heat, metal melts. These furnaces utilize gas as a fuel. The heat generated due to burning of the fuel gas raises temperature of the metal inside the crucible and melt the metal. Next is oil-fired tilting crucible furnaces. An oil-fired tilting furnace consists of an outer shell having a refractory lining inside. The hollow portion around the crucible forms a chamber through which circulates the burning fuel. The gases finally escape into the open atmosphere. Air at a definite pressure is supplied from the blower, and the oil comes from the oil tank through the oil preheater. The oil tank is kept at sufficient height and the oil is pumped into the tank. So this is the diagram of oil fired tilting crucible furnace. So at a height, that oil tank, from the oil tank, oil comes through the oil preheater and oil is pumped into the oil tank. So through the preheater it comes to the crucible furnace, and with the help of a blower, air is drawn into the furnace. So air and oil mixture enters into the crucible furnace chamber, where it is burnt and heat is generated. Due to this heat, the metal melts inside the crucible. So this is the diagram of the air flow. So this valve operates and controls the flow of compressed air through the nozzle into the furnace. As shown in the diagram, air from the blower and oil from the tank are fed through respective pipes into a common chamber denoted by F. A spindle S passes through this chamber, which acts as a valve. On pulling the spindle, the nozzle N is connected to the chamber and the mixture of air and oil start passing through the nozzle. For starting ignition, a small piece of cotton waste or cloth dipped in kerosene oil or similar other fuel is attached at C, as shown in the diagram, and the same is lighted. So ignition starts. Now the metal charge is placed in the crucible and the fuel supply is started. Once the fuel jet is ignited, there is no further need of this operation being repeated. The burning fuel encircles the crucible and the temperature of the metal rises, which ultimately starts melting. When the furnace is in operation, The crucible is kept perfectly vertical so that the heat generated due to burning of fuel is evenly distributed to all parts of the crucible. When the spindle is pushed in the nozzle, opening is closed and thus supply of mixture of oil and air is cut off from the furnace. Valves A and B are provided in the oil and air pipes respectively to control the supply of air and oil. So once the spindle is pushed in the nozzle, these valves closes the flow of air and oil respectively. When the complete metal charge has been melted, the fuel supply is cut off and the molten metal is collected in a separate ladle for pouring. For collecting this metal, the furnace is tilted along with the crucible by means of the tilting wheel, which operates through a set of gears. A spout is provided at the top of the furnace, which enables a well-directed flow of the molten metal. So this tilting mechanism helps to spout the molten metal into the ladle. So this is all about crucible furnace. So furnace basically is a chamber where we use some fuel and air such that once it is ignited, it burns and generates heat and raises temperature. With the help of this heat, the metal started melting, and this melted metal, molten metal, is taken for casting. Depending on the construction and use of the fuel and the process through which this metal melts, it is classified into various types. So two types have been discussed. One is cupola furnace, which is basically used to melt pig iron and ferrous metals. Second one is crucible furnace, which is basically used to melt non-ferrous metals, but it can also be used for pig iron. And this crucible furnace is used for small casting, where small volume of molten metal is required.